Yes, good evening students. So today we will discuss about motivation. Okay, the next topic we have, and we'll start the class within 2 minutes of time. Okay, so let's wait for us to join and then we'll start the class. Okay, so today's topic of discussion will be the motivation, the next chapter we have. Okay, and this motivation chapter basically is divided in two parts. So today we will discuss about motivation and the different theory, because motivation is chapter we'll cover up in two lectures. Okay, so today, and we'll discuss one more case study today, I think so. Okay, and I think so, yesterday I have given you one assignment, and that assignment you're supposed to complete, that is about that case study, I think so, if you remember. Okay, so I think let me start the session now, and we'll start the basic concept of motivation right now. Okay, let's start, I think so. So first of all, we will discuss the basic concept of motivation, and then we'll move to the different features and the different hierarchy and the models of motivation. Okay, so one by one we'll start all these items. Okay, so I can see that Poonam has joined, and one more student has joined the session now. Miss Poonam, have you completed that case study? I think so, and you were supposed to submit that case study as well. Okay, and today we'll discuss one more case study, fine? And in between, if you have any query, you can raise your hand, we can discuss those parts, fine? So let's start the session now, please. That is motivation. Yes, Poonam, please tell me.
Sir, I haven't got the question, sir, the case. So how to get the question and case?
I told you, I think, to take the screenshot of that case study, I think.
Sir, okay, I will, for the last moment, I will on my mobile, sir. I will go on mobile.
Yeah. Do one thing, I'll share that case study again. Just take the screenshot of that case study. And today we'll discuss one more case study, fine?
Okay, sir. Okay.
So let's start the next topic now, that is motivation. So first of all, when we discuss about this particular topic, what is motivation is all about, we'll discuss the definition part or the concept part of this particular topic. Okay, so when we discuss about this particular topic, motivation, okay, let me open it, I think we will discuss this topic. Yes, right. So first of all, we will discuss and we'll understand what this motivation is all about. Okay, so as you know that the word motivation is basically derived from the word that is called motive, which means the active form of a desire, okay, or a craving or need that must be satisfied. Now always remember, when we discuss motivation, when we talk about the motivation part, okay, the motivation, if you are taking the example of organization, okay, organization, we always know that a particular, you could say, financial or non-financial motives, financial and non-financial motives are always very, very important. So just that, I think so. There are some issues. 1 minute, please. Yes, Ms. Poonam, my voice is audible, I think. Is it clear?
Yes, sir, your voice is not clearly coming.
Can you please unmute yourself? I think my voice is clear. Ms. Poonam. I think. Please kindly,
yes, sir,
you can unmute yourself.
Yes, sir.
Now it's good. Now it's okay. Yes, Ms. Poonam. Now it's okay. I think let me unmute everyone. It's okay now. Fine. So when we discuss about the first of all, what is motivation? So motivation actually is derived from the word motive. Okay, and the motive means basically desire to achieve something. Okay, for example, when we discuss about an organization, and in an organization, when we talk about, you could say a particular person. Yes, and sorry for the interruption. I think there was some network issue actually. Okay. This particular word motivation as we are discussing right now. This motivation is basically derived from the word motive, which means the active form of desire, craving, or a need that must be satisfied. Okay, now when we are discussing about this particular component, the desire or a craving or need that must be satisfied, it means that these needs may be, you could say, like for example, because the motivation is such a you could say concept which may work in a professional world as well as in your competitive exam. The motivation may be something what actually want to achieve. So each and every individual, that motivational factor or that particular, you could say, a goal, which maybe you could say financial or maybe non-financial in nature as well. Okay. Now, when we're talking about this particular important part about the definition, it's a desire within an individual that stimulates him or her to action. Okay, it is a desire within. Individual that stimulus him. I think we discussed in the last class about what is stimulus. That stimulus him or her to act. Okay. It is a very simple concept about a stimulus. A stimulus means a particular target, a particular goal, which a particular person always want to achieve it. Okay, for example, like if you have joined a company as a clerk, now you want to become as an assistant manager, you want to become branch manager. Some network issue, I think, in my part. So just wait for 2 minutes, I think. So let me recorrect it, I think. Please wait for 2 minutes. Is my voice clearly audible? I think students, please kindly confirm. Is my voice clearly audible? Please, Miss Poonam, kindly confirm. Miss Poonam, please, you can unmute yourself. Is my voice clear? Miss Poonam, can you please unmute yourself? I think.
Yes, sir. The voice is coming, sir.
Yeah, yeah, sure. Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Thank you so much, Anuj. Let me share my screen again, I think. Yes, now. It is perfect, I think so now. Okay, fine. The next definition we are discussing, that is about this definition given by Robert Dublin about what this motivation is all about. Okay. Now, this definition says that it is a complex forces starting and keeping a person, at work in an organization. Now, when we discuss about this particular definition, about it is a complex forces starting and keeping a person at work in an organization. For example, you have started your own business of, you could say, a very small business of grocery. Now you want to, you could say, expand your business, and you have that hunger to actually become a very good businessman in the future. So what exactly you can do? Definitely, this is the starting and keeping a person at work. Means a particular stimulus, a particular motivation, a particular, you could say, hunger of a particular person will always actually enroute you, will always guide you at how a particular person can achieve the target or the goal or the, you could say, desire which he want to achieve in his or her life. So that is the second definition about the Robert Dublin. The third definition we'll discuss now, that is given by Vitals. Okay. The Vitals actually define this particular definition as an unsatisfied need. Which creates a state of tension, or disequilibrium okay, causing the individual to move in a goal directed pattern towards restoring a state of equilibrium. I'll explain the definition, okay? State of equilibrium by satisfying the needs. Okay. Now, what this definition is all about? When we talk about this particular definition. It is an unsatisfied need, first of all. Now, what is unsatisfied need? As I told in the previous definition as well, it is something basically which is being imagined, which is, you could say, a particular target or a goal of a particular person's life and what he wants to achieve. Because of the, you could say, target, what he wants to achieve, he has a set of disequilibrium in his mind, in his, you could say, life, that ultimately he wants to achieve something, and that tension, that hunger, actually always excites a person to achieve something. It is called disequilibrium, causing the individual to move in a goal-directed pattern towards restoring a state of equilibrium by satisfying the need. So ultimately, what we are talking right now, where the person is right now, and ultimately what exactly he wants to achieve in his or her life. That is again the definition which is given by the Vitals. Okay. Now, let me talk about this particular definition which we have covered up till now. Okay. There are a certain basic functionality or certain basic characteristics which we can actually understand from this particular topic. Okay. So let's move to the next part, that is about the major outcomes of a motivation. Okay, or let's say major traits or major definitions or major, you could say, points which we can actually focus on when we talk about the motivation. So, major factors. Okay, the number one, when we discuss about over here, the first and foremost thing, the basic part about motivation, it is basically a inner psychological force. It's an inner psychological force. Okay, the very first one. Okay, and as I told you that this inner hunger, this inner force, is actually compels a particular person, always excites a particular person in order to achieve something. So first and foremost thing, it is an inner psychological force compels an individual to achieve something. Okay. The second definition we have, that is about the, this motivation is basically influenced by personality traits. Okay. It is influenced by personality traits. Now, what are personality we are talking right now? That any personality. I think we, if you remember, then the previous session we discussed about type of personality. So when we discuss about the personality traits, this particular motivation is always based on personality traits and the learning ability, perception, and competence of an individual. Okay. So even when we discuss about personality traits, when we talk about, you could say, the learning abilities of a particular person, so it is basically influenced by the personality traits, the learning abilities, and competencies of an individual. Learning abilities and competencies of an individual competencies of an individual. Okay. Now, these are the, you could say, the particular, you could say, trait which we're talking right now. Now, trait means the particular personality type we're talking right now, the learning ability of a particular person, and how competent a particular person. Accordingly, that the motivation may vary. Okay. Now, when we discuss about this particular motivation factor, the motivation is directly proportional to efficiency of a person. Okay, so always remember, when it is the motivation, it is directly proportional to the efficiency of a particular person. So that is again the one of the most important trait about motivation. Okay, the third and the fourth part about the motivation which we are talking right now, that is, the motivation always originate, or you could say the root cause of any motivation, which always comes from the need and want of an individual. Okay, so motivation originates from the needs and wants of an individual. Because ultimately this is a basic basic concept from where this particular motivation always derived from. Okay, so motivation always you could say originate from the needs and the wants of a particular individual. Okay, the next part is the fifth important part is basically this. It is a process of stimulating and channelizing the energy of an individual for achieving the goal of a particular person. Okay, so there is the next definition we have about this particular part, that is about the major factors about this particular stimulizing and channelizing energy of an individual. Okay, the next important part which we have in this particular motivation, it is always basically a very important part which help or which channelize a particular person the sixth definition. So just 1 minute, I think there are some network issue again I am facing today. Just give me 1 minute of time. So just wait for a minute. I'm just recorrecting my issues of network. Just give me 1 minute of time, please. Yes, students. Sorry for the interruption. So we are discussing the sixth point right now about this particular motivation. So the next point, when we are discussing about this particular part, that this motivation helps always to achieve the performance of particular individual. Okay, so the next point we have, that is about the motivation play a crucial role in order to improve the level of performance. It helps to improve the level of performance. And the last one we have, that is motivation is basically a degree which differs from individual to individual. Okay. It is a degree which may differ from a person to person. From a person to person. Depends on their personality, need, competence, and the other factors. So it all depends on the type of personality which the one person must possess. And according to that, the motivational factors may always vary. Okay. But the degree which may differ from person to person depends on types of personality, needs, competencies, other factors. So it is totally depends on a person to person how a particular person may achieve something in order to, you know, to attain it in their life. But it's a degree which may differ from person to person depends on their type of personality, need, competence, and other factors. Now the next part we will discuss now, features of motivation. Features of motivation. Now, when we talk about feature of motivation, there are basically four major features which we have under motivation. The first one is basically internal feeling and a force of person to action. It is an internal feeling and force. Internal feeling and forces a person to action. The second important point when we talk about it is a continuous activity. It is a continuous activity. Okay. The third point we have, it varies from person to person. We discussed already. It varies from person to person and from time to time. It depends on the condition as well. So according to that, the motivation factor may also differ. And the last one, this motivation, it may be positive or negative as well. So the major four factors we have under motivation which we are talking right now. Okay. So let's move to the next. The next topic we have, that is about the need-based theories to motivation. Okay, the next topic now. So now we'll discuss the major theories of motivation. Okay. So need-based theories the first theory which we'll discuss right now, that is called Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Okay, the first theory that is called Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Now, when we discuss about this theory, I'll just share the diagram with you first, and then we'll discuss this theory part. Okay? Just a minute, please. Let me copy this diagram, I think, on my screen. Just I'm just sharing this screen again. Just wait a minute. I'm just sharing this particular hierarchy with you, which belongs to motivational, that is called the Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Okay, so wait a minute, please. Let me share my screen again with you, and we'll discuss this theory part right now. That is about the Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Now, basically, when we discuss about this Maslow's need hierarchy theory, these theories basically based on how a particular individual in his or her life can achieve something. Okay, now these achievements basically may be in terms of their basic needs. You could say, when we discuss about you could say their social needs, their psychological needs. Okay, so the Maslow has actually given a particular hierarchy through which a particular person may achieve motivation, okay, with the help of achieving all such scales in his life. Okay, so first of all, the different stages this the Maslow has suggested, which include basically 5 stages. Okay, the first part is belong to your basic needs, or it is also called physiological needs, that is food, shelter. Okay, physiological needs. The second part, which is called safety needs, is safety and security, job security. Okay, the second part is called your social needs. We discuss all this point one by one. Okay, social needs. Then we discuss about the esteem needs, and then we have the last one, that is called the self actualization needs. Okay, now I'll just show you the diagram over here, and that diagram basically signifies about how this particular theory moves on. Okay, just a minute. So it's a very basic model about Maslow, and how actually Maslow has given these 5 theories. And these 5 stages in the Maslow's theory is starting always from physiological or basic need. Now, when we discuss about the motivation, for a particular individual's point of view, a particular basic needs must be satisfied. Now, basic needs in terms of their food, their shelter, when we discuss about, you could say, the temperature, the ventilation, or even like we talk about from the perspective of the organization. Like for example, if a worker is working in the company, so what basic need he expects from their employer? That is about the good working conditions, safety features, job security. This is called the basic feature we are talking right now. So always remember, from the organizational perspective, the physiological needs basically cover up the basic point, which is called your ventilation. Because I'm talking this particular chapter in the perspective of the organization. Okay, or it's a manufacturing organization. The ventilation, if we talk about. Okay, like we discuss about the food. Then we discuss about the water, the basic needs. I'm talking about a particular person. Okay, the food, the good, you could say, quality of water, or you could say filtered water. Okay, now these basically needs always include the wages of a particular person. Okay, the wages also comes in this particular condition. When we talk about environmental condition, because your company must not harm, or particularly because your action should not harm the environment as well. So environmental surroundings as well. These are the basic features which always come to the mind. And these Maslow have given this particular five hierarchy of five stages, which start from the basic need of an individual, whether it's come to your personal life or a professional life, or even when we talk about this particular things in this in the category of we can say a worker working in the company. Now, second part is called the safety or security needs. Okay, the safety or security needs, like when we talk in a general sense, that is about we call nothing but the physical and emotional security of a particular person. Okay, now these securities basically having house, having good quality of cloth, job security, the basic part. I'll just type it over here. I think so. So like when we discuss about the second and important aspect about this particular safety needs, the safety need, the second part is called your job security. Okay. Or we discuss about, you could say, safe working condition. Okay. And what else we can discuss in this particular part? Safe working condition, good grievances system, retirement benefits. Okay. Retirement benefits, etc. So these are the major points which come under safety needs. Okay. So this is the basic and important part which comes under safety needs. Okay. Now the next part which we'll discuss right now, that is about the social needs. Okay. Now when we discuss about this particular part, that is called social needs. The social needs are basically nothing but the belonging, the needs related to belongings of a particular person. Okay. Now, when we discuss about the belongings, okay, the belongings basically is all about like when we, you could say, when we talk about this particular person, not related to social needs, okay? Sorry, we have to discuss the social need, it's called belonging needs. These basically is all about the social aspect of human life, okay? And these social aspect of human life basically is all about which include love, affection, you could say the peer, the company, or the colleagues with whom they work always. So this is basically is all about relationship and the friendships. Okay. Now this relationship and friendship on the job, which includes your, say for example, let me type this, relationships. You could say friendships, or you could say friends at the workplace. So it's a very basic important part which comes under category of your relationship and friends at the workplace, or even in the personal life as well. That would come under category of your social needs. The next part we have, that is called about your esteem needs. Okay. Now esteem needs are basically nothing but there are two types of esteem needs which we can discuss right now. That is positive self-image and self-respect. Okay. So self-respect in society, self-respect in the company. Okay. When we discuss about the recognition in the society or recognition in the company. Okay. And we talk about respect as well. Okay, we talk about respect as well. Okay, we can discuss about self-image as well. So the main basic point about which comes under esteem needs. And the last point which we have, that is called the self-actualization. Okay, the self-actualization is basically nothing but it is a top hierarchy of this particular Maslow need hierarchy theory. Okay, now the self-actualization basically comes under, you could say, one's potential, their growth, their development since they started working. So self-actualization needs is basically nothing but it involves realizing one's potential for continued growth and individual development. Okay. 1 minute. So the last part we have under this particular theory, that is called self-actualization. And it basically belongs to realizing one's potential for continued growth, and individual development. Okay, so the very important, the basic part which we are discussing right now about this particular topic, that is about the five basic stages of a human life, that is called this particular portion of Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Okay, because today we'll discuss only this one theory, and we'll discuss one important case study again today, because now we'll go with the with few important part and then one case study, few important part and one case study. Okay, so is there any doubt to anyone? We can discuss the doubts till this point about, we discuss about the motivation, we discuss about its basic definition, the factors, the features, the need-based theory, that is Maslow's need hierarchy theory. Okay, and tomorrow definitely we'll cover up the next model, that is called ERG theory, two factors theory. Okay, so the major two topics are left, and that we'll discuss in Bloom's expectancy theory. Okay, so these topics are left now, and that we'll discuss in tomorrow's class. Okay, today we'll discuss one more case study. Okay, and the answers for the same, you have to submit it during the class timing only, fine, on my email ID, fine. So let me share one case study with you. Yeah, first of all, let me unmute everyone. And is there any query till this point to anyone? I think, yeah, I've unmuted everyone, please. Any query till this point?
No.
Okay, Param, thank you so much. So we are discussing one more case study. And student, like the case study which I have given you yesterday as well, I just need the answers on my email ID, okay? So let me give you one case study based on motivation only. Okay, just wait a minute, please. So I'm just sharing one case study with you, and we'll discuss that case study in today's class. Okay, just a minute, please. The case study is basically nothing but it's not fair. Okay, let me, I think, share this screenshot on this, on the, yeah, it's fine. 1 minute, please. I'm sharing that case study with you. Okay, so let's start with this case study now. I think let me share my screen with you, and we'll discuss this case, and you have to solve these four questions today. Okay, wait a minute, please. I hope so. The case study is visible to everyone. The case incident number one, it's not fair. Okay. Okay, this case study is basically based on the basic motivational factor of an individual. So please start reading the case. I'm giving you 15 minutes of time for that. And the next half we'll discuss about this particular case study. Okay, please do it. Everyone, please, once you are completed, please kindly raise your hand. Okay, so that I could understand that you have completed the case, reading of the case only. Okay, and then we'll discuss this case study over here. Yes, and I'm waiting for a completion. Okay, very simple case study we have, and one more case study which I'll give you for your homework as well. Okay, so that you have to complete. Okay, just complete this case study now. Okay, I'm giving 15 minutes of time. We'll discuss this case study sharp 6 o'clock. Yes, student. Once you have completed, please kindly raise your hand. Okay. Yes, friend, done, I think. Or shall we wait for a few minutes? Okay. We are waiting for 5 more minutes, please. Okay. And then we discuss. We have to solve these questions as well, students. Okay. And I'll ask the question one by one with all. Okay. Just kindly read the case. Because this case is basically all about the payment system, about the how the compensation committee actually decided about what type of payment system which they have to give. And whether the payment system which they have decided, is it fair or not? That we need to discuss over here based on these 4 questions. Okay. Okay, I think Ms. Poonam, you are done. Good. So I'll start with you only with the first question. What exactly should be the answer of the first question? Okay. Just wait for, I think, 2 to 3 minutes more, and then we'll start with everyone. Okay. Just wait for 2-3 minutes, please. Yes, students, have you gone through with that? I'm unmuting everyone. Okay. And we'll discuss this case study and all the questions now. Okay. I'm unmuting everyone. So, Ms. Poonam, can you please summarize this case study, I think?
So, the case study is, it is a comparison of among the different organization, that if their top executive are getting the same salary, the other organization is also following that same pattern. Okay. So they are not going for the success, the working conditions of the employee.
Okay. So, okay. Yes, continue, please.
So there is a need for a top management to refer the situations, how the lower management is working and how their success should be rewarded.
Okay.
Yes, sir. That much I have understood.
Okay, understood, ma'am. Very good, but it's a good try actually from your side. What about other students? What is the gist of this case study actually? Mr. Anuj? Yes, any other student, please. You can unmute yourself. Yeah, please continue.
I will agree with the Poonam. This is the basically cases lower grade people to upgrade the in this structure. This is the actual theme of this case. Hello.
Okay. Yes, Mr. Anu, you're audible.
Because if the lower staff is efficient work, then the companies grow and all the things is so happen. This is okay. The main call for this.
Fine. Perfect. So okay. Any other student who want to conclude this case study? Any other, you could say, angle of thinking about this case study?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, please continue.
While the top executives, go to the lower level to understand their practical difficulties, what they also feel that these guys are, these executives are moving away from their own tasks. So by spending more time with the lower people, while they're able to gather their practical difficulties, they are not able to do justification to their own job profiles or job tasks. That is something which has been pointed out as a negative thing. That's what I understood from this case.
Whether it's Poonam, Manoj or you, basically different people have their different angle of thinking. And that what actually we are actually looking forward in this case studies. Okay. Now what we will do actually, students, the question which we have, these four questions, I just want that your question must be submitted on my email ID, the answers for the same. Because actually the case study is very simple. We can discuss one more case study, I think so. Okay. And we'll discuss that case again. And you just submit both the answer. And I'm expecting the answer for yesterday's case as well. Okay. So I'm just sharing one more case study with you. Okay. And just kindly go through with that case as well. Okay? Just one second, please. The second case is basically all about bullying the bosses. Okay? Just let me enlarge this one. 5 minutes. So this is a half of this case actually. And... Okay, 1 minute. So you can start with this reading of this case. I think I'll show you this case one by one. Okay. This is the first half of this case. Okay. And then the second half of this case. Okay. Just complete the first half and do let me know if you have completed. And then I'll just move to the second half of this case study. Okay. Please start. Yes, friend, done this first half, please. Done this, mute yourself, I think. I'll give the right to you. Done this first half, the bullying bosses.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Yes, students, please kindly confirm.
Yes, yes.
Okay, okay, fine. I'm just moving to the second half of this case now. Okay. So the second half of this case study, you can see that on my screen. And please come in. And student, please kindly just go through these questions as well, okay? Just giving you 10 minutes of time, please. Just complete this case now. And we'll discuss this particular case again.
Thank you.
Students, I think I'm facing some network problem actually. So what I will do, I'm just sharing that case study with you. Okay. So you just take a screenshot and I think you just submit this case study, because both the case studies are very important when it's come to this motivation chapter. Okay. So I think this is the first, sorry, this is the second case and its question. If you can take, just take the screenshot of this case, the first case, that is, it's not fair. Okay, that is based on compensation of the employees. And the second case is all about bullying the bosses. Okay, this is the first half of this case study and the second half of this case study. Okay. So what I will do actually, I will share these three cases, because one we discussed yesterday and today two cases. I will just mail to the IIBM Institute and they also, I think, mail you. Okay. And you can just submit me on my email ID. As I told you already, that is ankitwaliassignment@gmail.com. Okay. So student, I'm just winding the class early today because of some network problem I'm facing in my laptop. And tomorrow definitely we'll continue the motivation and few more case study about this particular topic. Okay. Sorry for the inconvenience, and we'll discuss the remaining topics in tomorrow's class. Thank you so much.